subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications. Hi friends, here is one of the most popular special class on MCET platform, which is MCQs on electric current. You can watch this video on Unacademy platform. Link will be in the description box below. If you click on watch now, you'll be redirected to the page and you can directly watch this video. There are also similar classes on optics, rapid fire quiz on work, energy and power, and also problem solving sessions, quick revision on mechanical properties. You can find more such kind of similar courses and plus classes. There are also upcoming sessions on Unacademy on all the subjects, basically chemistry, biology, mathematics. So links are down in the description box. Please do check out and don't forget to subscribe to Unacademy Plus. Okay, if you register for Unacademy Plus, you'll be able to access multiple courses at just affordable prices, and also you can give many mock tests. Okay, so just don't forget to check it out. Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we're going to see one of the most important question coming to physics for MCET. So now let's begin this video without any delay, okay? So coming to the question, the period of oscillations of a simple pendulum in an experiment is recorded as 2.63 seconds, 2.56 seconds, 2.42 seconds, 2.71 seconds, and 2.80 seconds respectively. Okay, so this is the given question, and what is he asking us to find? He is asking us to find the absolute average error. Okay, so now let's see how to solve this problem. Okay, so what are they asking us to find? Absolute average error. Okay, see, in this question only they are clearly giving hint that first we need to find the average value. So now let's see how to find the average value. So coming to the average value, how to find the average value? We just need to add all the given values divided by number of given values. See, I'm explaining. First, in the numerator, we need to add sum of the values. Okay, so these five are the values which they have given. Now, we need to find the sum of them, which is 2.63 plus 2.56 plus 2.42 plus 2.71 plus 2.80. We are done with numerator, and coming to the denominator, number of values. Okay, so how many number of values are there? 5. So we can directly write 5. Okay, so when you simplify this, we will be getting 2.62 seconds as average value. Okay, so 2.62 seconds is the average value which we just found out. Okay, so till here we are clear, right? So directly we are writing the average value which we just found, which is 2.62 seconds. Okay, we need to find the differences between the given values. Okay, first what we need to do is we need to find the difference value between the average value which we found and the first value which is given. Okay, delta t1 is equal to, we are denoting this difference with the value t. Okay, delta t1 is equal to the first value, the first time which is recorded, which is 2.63 seconds, minus the average value which we found, which is 2.62 seconds. Okay,
So now when we find the difference, we will be getting 0.01 second. Okay. Okay. Now we have found the value of delta T1, right? Now what we need to do is we need to find the value of delta T2. Okay. What we did in delta T1, we found the difference between the first given value and the average. In delta T2, we need to find the difference between the second value and the average which we found. Okay. So 2.62 minus 2.56, where the difference is 0.06. Okay. So next is delta T3. Delta T3 is also very easy. You just need to find the difference between third value and average. 2.62 minus 2.42, which is 0.20. Okay. So like this, we need to find the differences. We need to find for other values also. At T4, delta T4 is also very easy. The difference between fourth value and the, which is 0.09. The difference between fifth value and the average, 2.80 minus 2.662, which is 0.18. Okay, so now we found all the values from delta T1 to delta T5. Okay, so we need to find the average of newly found values. Okay, so now let's see how. So delta T is equal to, which is delta T1 plus number of values. Okay, 5 values. Okay, we already know the values of all this, so just substitute and you will be getting 0.54 in the numerator and denominator as it is, and once we solve this we'll be getting 0.11 second. So this is absolute average error.
So yeah, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching.